subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss any video from
Yo on LCameraTV. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share our whole things on Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and wherever else. And guys, I'm doing an episode review of a new anime. It's called Mirai no Katara, whatever. But on Crunchyroll it's called How to Keep a Mummy. So it's episode one. I'm gonna tell you what I think about it. And let's get started. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys, man. I like the anime, man. It's lighthearted, man. It's about a very small-sized mummy that the kid Sora, his dad, sent him from Egypt that he has to take care of. And at first, he didn't want to take care of it. He obviously wanted to send it back. His dad sent him some crazy stuff before, so he thought it was going to be dangerous. Then once he found out it wasn't dangerous and all that stuff and how cute it was, because it's like pint-sized, you know, it's a chibi kind of thing, you know, he decided to keep it. And I like it, man. It's a lighthearted anime. I usually go for the action anime myself, you know what I'm saying? Fighting and, you know, all that stuff is what I care for, what I tend to gravitate towards. But, you know, sometimes it's good to watch a little lighthearted anime. But the other thing I have to bring up, man, is that I left the anime with more questions than answers, man. Like, you know, obviously it's a cute little mummy, but what kind of mummies are pint-sized like that? And also, why is it eating dog food and acting more like a dog than a human? I don't know. But it's cute and, you know, obviously it's lighthearted. It was kind of funny, you know, maybe laugh a few times. So I'm definitely for it, you know, if you got the spare time. It's not a must-see for me. I mean, it's just one of the newer animes that, you know, if you want to watch something lighthearted, nothing too heavy, check it out, you know what I'm saying? It's okay. But it's definitely, if that's you like that type of stuff, you like that chibi and all that stuff, like whatever, I think you'll like it. But, you know, to be honest with y'all, you know, it's our anime, man. It's okay. If I had to grade it, I'd give it a solid C. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the anime. It's all right, but it's just, I mean, it's nothing. It's not a must-see for me. It's nothing too, you know, spectacular or anything like that that would really draw you in or hook you in, besides the cuteness of the little mummy. So, I mean, I'll give it a solid C. It's, you know, if you have the time and you know, want to watch something lighthearted, check it out. But, you know, if you're backed up on anime or stuff like that, whatever, trust me, there's way better anime you can watch. Well, that's it for me, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share with your things like Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and wherever else. And get in the comment section, man. Let me know what you think about How to Keep a Mummy. Do you like it? Do you dislike it? For me, it's like, it's an average anime to me. So, let me know. See y'all next time.